Jehovah, we thank you.
Hallelujah.
For your faithfulness.
Yes, Lord, thank you.
For your kindness.
Yes.
For your mercifulness.
Thank you, Lord.
For your benevolence.
Thank you, Jesus.
Your unchanging God.
Yes.
Set by two immutable things.
Oh, yes.
By which it is impossible for God to lie.
Oh, yes.
His purpose and his promises.
Oh, yes.
Can never change.
Oh, yes.
The unchanging God.
Yes.
The reliable God.
Yes.
You have been faithful.
Oh, yes.
Even when we are alone,
mm.
When there was no one with
us.
David said, I come unto the Lord, and he helped me. He took my feet from the miry clay and planted it upon the rock. The dependable God, the reliable God, incomparable God, indispensable God, irreplaceable God. God, we honor. God, we honor. Blessed be your holy name. You are faithful. You are faithful. Is somebody thinking about it? If you can think, you can thank. Thankful people are thankful people.
Oh, yes.
Can you think about his goodness? You can pray at me, but you cannot praise at me. Can you think about his goodness? When you are alone, when it appears that your finances have gripped the bottom, the pit, but you are God is there.
Yes.
You call unto him, but he answered.
Yes.
This God is faithful. As for this God, he shall be our God, and forever he shall be.
Amen.
We honor you. I want somebody that will honor God. I want somebody that can think. I want somebody that can thank you. There are three people that are in church. Those people that are watching, who's going to fall next? What's going to happen there? And the other set of people are the people that make things to work. They focus on God. Here I am, oh God. And the other people are the people. They are just there. I don't know which group you belong to. God is hearing, God is with us tonight. You see, what God has done is forever.
Amen.
No one can add to it, no one can remove from it.
No.
Therefore, there are certain things that he has put in place for 2018.
Yes.
It is true, we have about 1.5 hours to go, about 1 hour to go. But you see, 2018 has already taken place.
Oh, yes.
For faith, all of those things that be not as though they were.
Mm.
They are not going to be, they already be.
Amen.
That's why you are here.
Amen.
You already made it, that's why you are here.
Amen.
You are not in the grave, that's why you are here.
Amen.
You are alive, that's why you are here.
Amen.
Despite the doctor's diagnosis, you are still here.
Amen.
That's why we are
thank you. Thank you.
So the scripture says in 1 Corinthians 2, 9, I have not said,
oh, yes.
As it is written,
oh, yes.
I have not said,
oh, yes.
Nor as he heard, nor as it enters the heart of any man, that which God has revealed.
Oh.
It's not going to prepare, it has been prepared.
Yes.
2018 has been prepared.
Amen.
For the words we understand, Hebrews 4, Hebrews 11, 2. We understand in verse 3, that the words were framed by the word of God. So that the things that appear are not made from the things that are visible. So the invisible is more real than the visible. 2018 is already in existence. And you will make it.
Amen.
And in fact, you have made it.
Amen.
I want to begin to thank God for his faithfulness. I want to begin to thank God for his faithfulness. It is true there are some near misses in 2017. But that shall no longer be said anymore. Because God is in the lead. I said God is in the lead.
Oh yes.
Psalm 43:18, he said, I shall do a new thing.
Oh yes.
I shall do a new thing.
Yes,
I said God is in the name.
Amen.
Do not look at what has gone, what has happened, what has gone wrong. Because God is a restorer.
Yes.
I said God is a restorer.
Amen.
Tonight, God will show on our case.
Amen.
Yes, we worship you, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you. We honor you.
Hallelujah.
We honor you.
Hallelujah.
My soul doth magnify the Lord. And my spirit praises His name.
Tried everything on the hook on the doorpost to see pastor trying to put on thing. I said, Jesus is Lord.
Amen.
But you see, for God has healed me.
Amen.
Thank God.
Thank you, God. The death visited me. You see, you have the option whether to say yes or to say no. But I decided to say no.
Hallelujah!
I saw death.
I don't know about you. You say he's a doctor, so what? You say he's a pastor, so what? For many are the afflictions of the righteous.
Oh, the Lord God.
But the Lord delivered them out.
Amen.
I'm not joking. My family knows about it. And some of you that are close to me, I told you. You know? But you see? God is on the throne.
Oh yes.
I don't know what you have gone through. You will not know that the pastor was having those. Because I was just dancing.
Yes.
But you see, many of us will wear this collar and everything. You don't know what we are covering.
That's right.
But when the rubber meets the road, it's only you and God. And what you believe. Oh, thank you.
Thank you, Father.
I don't know about you. I think I want to hear some testimonies about you. Because in this church, pastor always talks a lot about his own testimony. And people always hear and listen. You know? But haven't you seen it all? Haven't you also, can't you testify about the goodness of God? Hasn't God done something unique in your life? Hasn't God saved you from near misses? Genuinely. Has anybody been there at the point of death? Has anybody really been there alone? You want to call on your wife or your husband, but there's no one there. But God is there with you.
Amen.
For He said, I will never leave you.
Not forsake you.
Hallelujah.
You want to end. Come on, sit down. Quickly. That's why we're here. We're here to celebrate what God has done in our lives and what God will do. And this is a Bible believing church. We'll be making testimonies. Let's hear.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
31st of December. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
People in
the church, I'm excited. I'm really excited. My testimony really is when I lost my mom, those that know where it happened, I lost hope. And one thing I always tell people in life is whatever you do, don't lose hope, because people that lose hope are the ones that commit suicide. And that's why I was really worried for me. But I'm in the right place.
Amen.
Find your way to the right place. Don't only come to the right place on the 31st of December. Amen.
Amen.
And God
pulled me out. It was, I was in a very dark place and I didn't care about my kids. I didn't even want to know. It was all about me and how I was feeling and how much I missed her and how it was just about me and how I was feeling. But God reminded me that my children didn't choose me. They I chose them. Does that make sense? Because sometimes as parents, we forget that when things are happening around us, we forget that the children didn't choose us. You chose them. Does that make sense? And your caretakers. So I'm so blessed by this church. I just thank God. My kids have made it to the end of the year. My kids are in secondary school, three of them. Who would have thought, reaching and look at me, alone with God. It is possible, people, just put God first. A lot is going to happen in 2018. Amen?
Amen.
Do you believe it?
Yes, I believe it.
The good thing is that we don't even choose our children as well. Because those guys, millions of them, they just run and attack one particular thing. And before you know it, so we didn't choose them. We are just stewards, that's right. Amen.
Amen.
And as stewards of God's children, we have to bring them up in the will of the Lord.
Amen.
Who says single parents cannot make it? You can. Looking unto
Jesus,
the author
and the finisher of all our faith.
Regardless of any condition, God is in control.
Amen.
I believe that this will challenge you. Just listen. Yes. Let's. Oh, Sister Cookie, yeah. Man, the message, but well, let's see that. Message has started. From here, I will get
Anyway, my message is just, I can't say it's funny, because it happened yesterday. You know, there is something in me, if God lead me to do something, I always obey God. I have this game. We normally play game on phone and everything. Even my son will say, Mommy, what's wrong with you? You are in this game. And this one is casual people, I normally, on that game, I created it just like a festival something. And this lady, we normally chat to each other, she gave me Palestina. I said, Palestina, where is it, Palestina? But in my heart, I said, there is something that make me and you to connect on this game. It's not just for ordinary. So yesterday it comes, so I was just texting everybody, greeting everything, everything, how are you? And then, all these people, they are from on this nation. So this lady called me and said, oh, sister, she hasn't got a sister. Oh, she will choose me as a sister. I said, that's fine. And I said, are you a Christian? She said, no, she's a Muslim. I said, we are one with God present. So, so yesterday she texted me. I didn't see it in time. So I called up her back with my messenger. And when I told her, she said, oh, sister, I don't know what to do. My daughter, she has a little baby, she's 5 months old, and she says she's in coma. See, in coma? And that spirit just told me, say, okay, are you where the lady, baby is? She says she's not there. They've taken her to intensive care. I said, okay, don't worry. There is no way that prayer will not go, and prayer will meet her wherever she is. I said, can you just place your hand on your tummy? And I started praying with her. I said, no matter what doctor say, no matter any report, I always give the report of the Most High.
Yes.
I said, but you are Muslim, you did not know the God has said. Yes. But I know the God has said is able. Yes. Even they say to you, she said, no, sister, I'm afraid. I said, don't be afraid, sister. Everything is going to work. Everything is going to be fine. Before you go home, they are going to tell you that your daughter, she's already made her conscious.
Yes.
So she now will pray, I pray with her. I said, God is there, he's doing his healing. He said he sent his word and healed the disease.
Yes.
I said, I don't care what the doctor has said to you.
Yes.
And I said, baby, she said, I said, did you believe in my God? I said, but you don't know him, but did you believe in him? And he said, yes, sister, I believe you. You always have lots of Christians. I said, you may have a lot of Christians, but they didn't show you the truth, the way the God I'm serving.
Yes.
So I pray with her, I pray everything. I said, before I left where I am now, you are going to text me back and give me the gift result. So, to God be the glory. God is faithful. He's in heaven. She just texted me. Just 2 hours later, she said, oh, sister, I'm happy. She's out of coma. I said, oh, glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, I was showing it to my son. I said, don't worry, everything will be okay. They will give your daughter to you by going tomorrow. She said she has to go and sleep. That was yesterday, 1 o'clock. And I was 12 o'clock. I said, I will continue to pray. And I will pray. They will give your daughter to you. Sister, you are not single, but a single parent too. I have 3 children. Once she just graduated, she's going to, next year, November, she's going to be wed.
Wow.
She's going to marry.
Wow.
Amen. You know, I can't say a lot of things. We are doing things we don't do. But we serve a God of wonder. God that can put you through and do all things. At times, even my own brother, he was saying, oh, I wish I had a wife like him. I said, don't be jealous. Don't tell me that crap. I said, at times in life, you don't know what you're going through, but God is there. He's going to walk that way with you, and everything will come to pass. You will just support your children. Amen. Thank you. Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
One more.
Yes.
Let's give room for. Oh, sorry, my dear.
I just want to say.
Very nice.
Bye-bye.
But the Spirit is telling me, come out, testify. Concerning my health, I have to, sorry. Concerning my health, I give God the glory. I've been hearing a lot of things that people have been saying, no, I'm a Christian. But because it has not happened to me, I don't really get it. God is the miracle God. I saw the Spirit, the angel, sitting down and you know, begging God on my behalf and saying, let's give her drugs because I'm diabetic.
Mm-hmm.
And I give God the glory.
Right.
And they gave me the drugs and I took it. Then I said, what am I going to have another one? They said, when time comes, when you need it, we'll call you. Throughout that week or that month, I won't feel anything. I just want to appreciate God for what he has been doing in my life. Because so many things have been, you know, going wrong, you know. But I give God the glory. 11 years now or 12 years I, you know, diagnosed. My kidney is still functioning. Liver, everything is still intact. Why am I saying it? I don't want to come out. But I'm saying it because I want you to know that this God, there's no other ways. It's only him that can do it. It's only him. There's no other way. And I give God the glory again for my ministry. I thank God for my children, for my mother, for my family. I give him praise and I will continue to praise him. Hallelujah.
Amen. That's it. If the Lord has done it, amen. If God has done things, it comes out natural, isn't it? If you have been to hell, if you have been to hell, and he took you out of hell, they will not even ask you. You will say, amen.
Yeah.
One more. Oh, Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Lord is good.
Hallelujah.
We decide to postpone that one, isn't it? Because we can go on and on. But it tells me something about testimonies that we all give. One of the names of Jesus Christ is wonderful. That means that wonders and signs are essential in the ministry of Jesus. And in Acts chapter 2, verse 43, many wonders and signs were done through the apostles. And that signs and wonders may be done through the name of the Holy Servant Jesus. Acts chapter 4 verse 30. So you can see that wonders and signs that the people have testified about tonight and more as people to testify were not limited even in the ministry of the apostles. Because in Acts chapter 6, verse 8 as well, not only were the apostles the ones that testified by the signs and wonders of God. Even Deacon Stephen, remember him? He was full of faith and power. He did great wonders and signs among the people. Even in the Old Testament, we had Prophet Isaiah saying in Isaiah chapter 8 verse 18, said, "Here am I and the children whom the Lord has given me. We are for signs and wonders." Why don't you talk to yourself? I am for signs and wonders. So we are for signs and wonders. Even in Mark chapter 16, verse 17, Jesus said, Jesus himself said, "And these signs shall follow them that believe." Who believes it? So, signs are to follow us. We are not to follow signs. Two different things. So because of that, if wonders and signs are paramount in the ministry of Jesus, the Lord told me that in this 2018 to come, and I want to mark this down in your diary, every third Friday of the month, we shall be having a night of wonders.
Amen.
I would like to employ ministers that sings and other people as well, because we want to make it evangelistic. If truly God performed wonders, which he did in my life, I'm a living witness to it. You see, some people can fake things. I'm not faking it.
Yes, sir.
You see, I've seen death, and I say I'm not going.
Yeah.
Amen?
Yeah.
In fact, one of the prophets said, "You are going to die." I said, "I'm here."
No.
The place you least expect, went for. I put on the clergy clothes as it is, and everybody put it on. And as we're going, something happened. And one of them looked at me and said, "You are going to die." And I looked at him because he was a man that I respect. You know, someone I respect is an American. You see? Well, I'm British. So when he said to me, "You are going to," you know, British are always polite. Amen.
Amen.
So I was polite. I said, "Excuse me, can you come again?" So give him benefit of the doubt, isn't it? And he had the audacity to say it again. He said, "He is going to die." I said, "Really?" And then suddenly, the scripture says, "Touch not my mountains."
All right.
And do my prophet
no harm. Hallelujah.
So don't you know? Greater is it that is in you than he that is in the world. So politely, I always smile when somebody steps on my toes. I said, "What you have said now, let it go back to you."
Yeah.
And I said, "I've just started." The man ran there. I'm not even finished. And I just took his gap, and then I said, "You would have waited so that you can hear me." So you can see why I'm rejoicing. For me to be here, amen? Can't you rejoice with me? And so that's why we are here, to testify about the goodness of God. So every third Friday of the month, can you please attend this a night of wonders?
Mm-hmm.
Mark it down in your diary. It takes all about 1 or 2 hours. If God performs wonders, then let it come to us.
Amen.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
Isaiah said, "Me and the children that God has given, we are for signs and wonders of Israel."
Yes.
So we are for signs and wonders in South End.
Yes.
Because the anointing you respect is what you should expect. Isn't it? So if you do not respect an anointing,
you should not expect it. The anointing that you respect is the one you should expect. So because I respect the anointing of healing, so I should expect it in my life. Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
So if you respect the God of wonders, so you should expect wonders in your life.
Yes.
Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Third Friday of the month, please, a night of wonders, the door shall be open there. So want everyone to be there. Let's challenge God. If that has the song, has life. If how many people have the song here? That's what it is. If you have the song, you have life. If you don't have the song, complete it. So mark it down. Joshua said in Joshua 3 verse 5, sanctify yourselves for tomorrow. The Lord will do wonders among you. Who does the wonders? So when we put program together, it says sanctify, set yourself apart for wonders. If you set yourself apart for wonders, the God of wonders will perform. So tell families and friends, bring the diseased people.
Come on.
People that are sick. After all, I was sick. Now I am healed.
Hallelujah!
Isn't it?
Come on!
Exactly. So the anointing you respect is the anointing you expect. What the bird has is what made the bird to fly. If I have nothing to fly with, but I have something to deliver.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
By that night of wonders, we shall pray for healing for sick people. We shall pray for salvation. We shall pray for God to perform wonders.
Yeah.
Because in this new year we are going, God told me, as you can see, it's the year of exceeding abundance.
Amen.
He has told us. So abundance in whatever area that you want in life. That's it. And it shall be.
Amen.
Everyone say it shall be.
It shall be.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So mark it down in your diary. In Luke chapter 5 verse 17. And the power of the Lord was present to heal them. Right now, where the word of God, where the word of the king is, there is
power.
Because the word of God is here, there is power here.
Amen.
You need to check your body. Whatever has brought you to here, you see, whatever you brought in here, is no longer with you.
Yeah.
Because where the word of God is being preached, and the power of the Lord was there, present to heal. What healed people? The power of God. Hallelujah.
Well, well, well. The Lord is good.
All time.
I said the Lord is good.
All time.
I'm just happy tonight for the reasons I've given you.
Yes.
The one that's supposed to have died, refused to die. And I had another sister say to me this morning as well that she too experiences body attack, affliction, you know, and God delivered her.
Hallelujah.
Christians can be. There are three things: oppression, affliction. I don't know. We have oppression, affliction, and possession. Possession is when something takes over you. Christians can be possessed because you can light and darkness cannot dwell together. So, for as many that are led by the Spirit of God, Romans 8:14, they are what? So, if the Spirit of God is in you, the devil cannot possess you.
Amen?
Amen.
Yeah.
Christians cannot be possessed.
Amen.
To be possessed is to be taken over by the devil. Amen?
Amen.
What about oppression? Luke chapter 13, there was a woman there that was kind of bowed down for how many years? 18 years. She could not rise up. That's an example of oppression. Can Christians be oppressed?
Yes.
If you open up to the wrong spirit, yes, it will torture you for a while.
That's right.
Until you repent.
That's right.
What about affliction? Is it Epaphroditus, brother Epaphroditus in the scripture? He was afflicted. Sickness. Just like saying, can Christians fall sick? See, whether you're a Christian or not, you can fall sick.
Yes.
Whether you're a bishop or not, it doesn't matter.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen.
So those three things, take note of it. Okay? Because it's not possible for light and darkness to dwell together.
Amen.
Are you with me?
Yes, Lord.
So tonight is so unique. It marks the end of an era and the beginning of another. Soon to happen. Are you excited? Is that
excited? Yes.
Only excited people will excel in life. So we need to be excited. See? Said, don't rejoice over me. But when I fall, I shall rise.
Hallelujah!
There is hope for the tree. If it is cut down, it will sprout. Job 14, verse 7, verses 7 to 9. Job 14, verse 7 to 9. And that its tender shoots will not cease. So I congratulate you tonight.
Amen.
Because there is hope for you.
Amen.
Though its root may grow old in the earth, and its stump may die in the ground. How many of you know that we die daily? We die daily to self. We die daily. Yet, at the scent of water, it will go. Again, I congratulate you tonight for being here.
Amen.
2018 has already taken place.
Oh, yes.
And you shall see more years.
Amen.
But very importantly, the message for the new year. The word repentance came up several times in the ministry of John the Baptist and in the ministry of Jesus the Christ. Matthew chapter 3. Verses 1 to 2. Matthew chapter 3, verses 1 to 2. In those days, John the Baptist came preaching in the wilderness of Judea, verse 2, and saying, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. In other words, John was saying, repent because God's kingdom is here. Again, Jesus began his ministry with the same message. Mark chapter 1, verses 14 to 15. Mark chapter 1, verses 14 to 15. Now, after John was put in prison, Jesus came to Galilee, preaching the gospel of the kingdom of God, and saying, the time is fulfilled, and the kingdom of God is at hand. The word at hand means has drawn near. We are in the kingdom of God.
Amen.
I am in the kingdom of God.
I am in the kingdom of God.
So repent. And believe in the gospel. The gospel of the kingdom of God. And the gospel is good news. When the angel came, that angel came to Mary, said, do not fear. Do not fear. I bring you good news of great joy. If repentance is not important, Jesus and John definitely would not have preached it through. So Jesus said, in the word of Jesus, said, repent and believe in the gospel, the good news
There is something powerful about repentance that if it is not done properly, it will stop anyone who have not yet repented from believing the gospel of Christ. Repent and believe in the gospel. The last message for the year, and definitely the first message in the new year today, is repent and believe. Repent and believe. One comes before the other, and the next comes after. The word repent is derived from the Greek word metamorpho. In other words, the meta means change, and the morpho means form. In other words, to repent is to change one's form, to change a change of mind. It is not sorry. Repent is stronger than simply say sorry. To repent is to change one's form. And this is where the English word metamorphosis or transformation comes from. So to repent and believe in the gospel is to begin to think differently. How is my life like this? Why am I going through this problem? If God is in me, why can't I stay in the dark? Why can't I switch the light off? Why am I always claustrophobic? I cannot stay in this space, in a closed space. Why? It is not true that everybody has their plan. God says, John 14:1, do not let your heart be troubled. You see, the weapon of offense or of attack of the devil to us is what? Fear. And the weapon of our own defense is to overcome the fear. As you can hear from all the testimony of people, they were there, you know. And I'm sure there are other people here. You see, what is important is, on the day of reckoning, the God that you have been serving before the day of trouble, if he cannot deliver you on the day of trouble, he is no God. Are you with me?
Yes.
So, to repent, therefore, is to think differently. If truly I am a child of God, why is this sin defeating me?
That's right.
If I am a child of God, why can't I stay with one person? Why am I lusting after people? You see, I can be calling it, you know which one is yours. So to repent is quite essential in our walk with God. That's why I say it's more than sorry. And this is a new thing. It's a new and living way. He said, by a new and living way which he consecrated for us through the veil that is his flesh. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 20. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 20. Every prayer you need to pray before we enter 2018. I have prayed for you.
Amen.
That's why I say you should congratulate yourself. But there's going to be a topping up, isn't it? Here tonight, which is important.
Because many of you are fully loaded. To top it up, isn't it? Because from the first day of the new year, some people are here. You begin that year with wonders.
Amen.
And I believe I'm the first among you. And this is why when Jesus was born, the angel and the host of heaven praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace, goodwill towards men. It is good. It is only by repentance, therefore, that the goodwill towards men can be realized. Repentance will open the door into the kingdom of God. That's why Jesus Christ said, repent and believe in the gospel. Because without repentance, it will be difficult for you to believe. To believe the gospel of God. I've never seen somebody that never repented and understood the word of God. It's just acknowledge. It's not deep. Revelation chapter 3, verse 20. Revelation chapter 3, verse 20. Behold, I stand at the door and knock. Not everybody hears him when God comes knocking. But those that are here tonight, you will hear him.
Yes.
So if anyone, that's everyone, everyone, if anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come in to him and dine with him, and he will be with me. Now, if God is in me, that's why Jesus was annoyed with Philip. When Philip said, show me the Father, that is sufficient. Jesus said, excuse me, I've been with you for so long, and you are asking, show me the Father. Don't you know, if you see me, you see the Father. If God with us, he said, the Father is in me, and I am in the Father. Do you know, as I'm talking right now, I am in the Father. And the Father is in me. Because I'm in the kingdom. That is why when the prophet of doom said somebody was going to die, he did not shake me a bit. At all. Because my death is not in the hand of the
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Even the doctor cannot kill you.
Amen.
Sorry, many doctors are here.
Hallelujah.
Because even the devil cannot kill you.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Never be you afraid of death.
Yes.
He said, I shall not die, but I shall live to declare the works of God. The reason why you will not die is to declare the glory of God. So if you are not declaring the glory of God, you will as well.
Come on.
Did you hear?
That's right.
And there's so many ways we can declare the glory of God. As a doctor, you can. In your workplace, you can.
Yes.
When you don't cheat. When you do your work conscientiously. He said Daniel was preferred above others because an excellent spirit was found in him. You see, an excellent spirit is not the Holy Ghost. An excellent spirit is a disposition. It's an attitude. An attitude of someone that works well, that is diligent, dutiful, truthful, God-fearing, sincere, honest, reliable, competent. That's an excellent spirit. Not a slothful spirit. So if you are a child of God, you have an excellent spirit. Promotion comes not from man, but comes from God.
when you are excellent, competent in what you are doing, what you are being paid for, he will promote you. That's why I know you will be promoted.
Amen.
In this new year, you will be promoted.
Amen.
If you believe that, say amen.
Amen.
But on the basis of repentance. Repent and believe. You see, you cannot even believe what I'm saying unless you repent. What does pastor say? You still be struggling to understand what he's saying. Because the heart is not there. But tonight, your heart is there.
Amen.
Repentance opened the door to letting him in into your life. The story was said about a woman caught in adultery. The very act. The time of Jesus. So she was brought to Jesus, and the accusers, who were males, said to her in verse 4, "Teacher," which was the title the scribes and the Pharisees called Jesus, said, "This woman was caught in adultery, in the very act." I wonder why it was only the woman that was caught in the very act. Doesn't it take you to tango? Where was the man? Verse 5. "Now Moses in the law commanded us that such should be stoned. But what do you say?" Verse 6. "This they said, testing him that they might have something of which to accuse him. These men have nothing good to do with their time." They were busybodies. They are fault finders. Today we have busybodies in families, as friends, in the church. In the church. Who have nothing good to do with their time? This, they said, testing him. So don't they know what they're doing? Testing him that they might have something to accuse him with. Some people already knew the answer. Yet they are looking for the scripture that will contradict the word of God. You see? And they are in the church. And the outsiders know that the people in the church hope to be doing what is right. From that testimony of that sister, it was a Muslim woman that was asking a Christian sister to pray for her and her child. Did you get the testimony? Yes. So if the outsider doesn't know that there's power in the church, they will not be asking that.
That's right.
So there are so many people that are not in the church, but they are part of the kingdom of God. That's why Jesus Christ said, "There are other people that are not in this fold. I am praying for them," John 17, "that they will come." Remember? And they will come.
Amen.
Because even tonight they are here.
Amen.
So, my advice to anyone that is looking to find fault with God is to stop it. Because it's a tortuous pathway. Verse 7 to 8. "So when they continued asking him, who? Are we okay? Open to John 8. That's because I have man in front of me. So it's John 8, pardon me, not Matthew 8. So we're reading John 8, verses 1 to 11. Verse 7 to 8. "So when they continued asking him, He raised himself up and said to them, he who is without sin among you, let him throw a stone at her first. And again he stooped down and wrote on the ground. What was he writing? No one knows. If it is that important, he will have known. But what is important is the message of repentance that he taught this woman. God has not sent his son to condemn the world, but that the world will be saved through him.
Amen.
John 3:17. So God has not come to condemn us, but to save us from sin. And I believe this is the message for someone here today. You've been going to church, but when you are alone, you know what you do. And tonight, that will come to an end.
Amen.
And in verse 9 of John chapter 8, then those who heard it, what did they hear? What Jesus has said, he who is without sin among you, let him throw a stone at her first. Those who had it, being convicted by their conscience, you see what they do? They went out one by one. So they are not saints after all. And Jesus was left alone, and the woman standing in the midst, in the middle. They went out one by one because they were convicted by their conscience. Thank God the conscience was alive. And as you are hearing me, your conscience is alive. Their conscience condemned their sin, their sinful lifestyles. The day your conscience stopped living, you are gone. So it's a good thing if your conscience convicts you that what you are about to do is wrong, or what you are doing is wrong. You will not be able to pray well. To which God? And that's why many of the people that are in the church, they don't have peace with God. But tonight, that will change.
Amen.
Because as you go into the new year, things are going to get better.
Amen.
Someone is here, your conscience is already telling you off. You see, that means that God is reaching out to you. And that's a good sign. He's reaching out to save you. He's reaching out that you should change your mind. Remember, change your mind. Metamorpho. Change the way you think. To repent and believe in the gospel, we need to do it. Verses 10 to 11 of the same chapter. When Jesus had raised himself up. At times, when Jesus was writing things down, he did as if he did not even listen to them. That's why at times you will pray and pray and pray as if God is not hearing you. He wanted to pray more.
That's right.
If that thing matters to you, you will spend some time praying. Remember, the anointing you do not respect, you should not expect. Even God knows what matters to you. But where the heart of the man is, that is where his treasure is. And where the treasure of the man is, that's where his heart is. So Jesus Christ had so many things, he would do as if he did not hear, but he wanted to bring more. So in this new year, you have to bring more to get it right. So he raised himself up and saw no one but the woman. So he said to her, "Woman, where are those accusers of yours? Has no one condemned you?" She said, "No one, Lord." And Jesus said to her, this is the point I want you to take notes. "Neither do I condemn you. Go and sin no more."
Hallelujah.
It is not God that condemns us. It is our conscience that condemns us. Repent and believe. So as we enter the new year, have a change of mind to serve God differently. To repent is to do things, begin to do things differently. To repent is to begin to think differently. We cannot be mediocres. We need to be deep with God. We cannot be worshiping God from a distance. Would this woman ever forget the day Jesus saved her?
No.
Hello?
No.
Would she?
No.
Would she ever go back into adultery again?
No.
Why did you say that? Because she knew the day that God delivered her from death. Because from now on, she had become a new person. She's no longer the woman caught in adultery, the very act, but the woman saved from death. Because for the wages of sin is death, according to Romans 6:23. But the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus, our Lord. If you ever repented, you can never forget the place of your death. Remember, we died daily. If you ever repented, ever, you can never forget the place of your death. The one that used to be an alcoholic, until Christ delivered him or her from alcoholism. Will she ever forget, or will he ever forget what God has delivered him or her from?
No.
So repentance is more than just sorry. It's more than that. If you had ever repented, you will not go back into sin. Because according to verse 7 of that same chapter, "For he who has died has been freed from sin." Verse 7. "He who has died has been freed from sin." He was died. He was
died.
He was
died.
Has been freed from sin. So if you have ever repented, you have died to that sin. That is the true meaning of repentance. When some people are saying, "I've repented," but obviously they are still doing it. They have not died. You need to die. You need to die to that sin. To repent is not to regret your action. When you repent, you are dead to the action. Should I say that again? To repent is not to regret your action. When you repent, you are dead. Turn to someone and say, "You are dead." You are dead to that action. And that is why it takes more than sorry to repent. When you repent, you have actually died to that sinful action. So, brothers and sisters, the message for the new year is for you to repent and believe in the gospel. The woman caught in the adultery will never forget the day she died to sin. So has God been warning you to change your mindset? Has your conscience been very active lately, convicting you of what you should stop doing, telling you to start doing things right? You know, God demands a change. He that is often rebuked and yet hardened his neck without any advance warning, destruction will come. May that not be a portion in the new year. So this is God calling you to repent and believe the gospel of the kingdom. If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves. 1 John 1:8 If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. 10 If we say we have not sinned, we make him a liar, and his word is not in us. He says his truth is not in us. His word is not in us. If our conscience keeps convicting us that this thing you are doing is wrong, because it's going to delay you from entering the kingdom of God. God's word cannot be in a man who is not admitting his wrong. Until you desire to change from within, you cannot hear from God. Because God's word is not in you. Very shortly, we're going to be 2018. Until you repent, therefore, you cannot believe in the gospel of Christ. You will know the scriptures, but you still cannot believe it. His word is not in you. The truth is not in you. You have not truly repented. No wonder many New Year resolutions are disastrous in the first hours, let alone first few days of the New Year, because they have no foundation of truth in that. But this year will be a different
year.
According to Psalm 65 verse 11 says, you will crown the year with your goodness and your path drop with abundance. So I have good news for the celebrants of today and those watching over the YouTube and those listening and those that are here. God will crown this year with his goodness for you. As you walk in his path, his path shall drip on you with abundance. But not if you are not ready to repent and believe. It cannot be business as usual, as we did last year or some years ago. It cannot be as we did in 2017. It has to be different. You have to think differently. This God cannot be mocked. There's someone here tonight whose conscience is already convicting you. God wants your heart. Let us pray. Will you ask him to save you tonight, so that the new year will drip on you abundant blessings? He said, whoever calls on the name of the Lord, Romans 10:13, shall be saved. Whoever calls upon his name shall be saved. Are you ready to call on God tonight to save you from the powers of sin, from those things that troubles your life? They did not win last year. They cannot win this year. Your destiny is not in the hand of any man. Your destiny is in the hand of God. By repentance and belief, we enter into it. Do not let your heart be troubled. You will make it. You will make it in 2017. See, you are going to make it again. You are making it in 2018. Welcome to this year. This is a new year for you. This is a new season for you. I decree and I prophesy over you. This year can be better for you. This is a year of exceeding. abundance. You will make it this year. Whoever says you will not make it has failed. But God is on the throne. God will promote you. God will go before you. He will grant the year for you with his goodness. He will grant the year for you with his goodness. And his mercy shall drink for you abundance. That which you failed to do last year, he shall not be out of your hand anymore. He shall not be out of your hand anymore. Come on, stand up on your feet.
Your heart
can perceive your hands will achieve. Receive grace for the new year.
Amen.
And let's begin to thank you. Begin to thank you. Begin to say, mountains shall depart, the hills shall be taken away, for my covenant of peace shall remain. Enter into a covenant of peace with God. Enter into a covenant of peace with God for you and your family this year. Enter into covenant of peace with God for your health. Enter into covenant of peace for your job, for your career. Enter into covenant of peace. Covenant requires you to do something and God will do it. Covenant requires you to obey God's word and God will do according to his promise. Lord, we bless you. Lord, we give you praise. Lord, we thank you. Praise. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we give you praise. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we give you praise. Begin to thank you. He's showing you a vision. He's showing you a plan for the year. Lord, we thank you. He's showing you what he wants you to begin to do. Receive it. I can see that. Receive it right now. The angels of God are dropping on you. Drips of abundance. Receive it. Receive it right now. You will make it. You will not fail. Your marriage will not destroy. Your health will improve. In the name of Jesus. Your vision shall come to pass. In the name of Jesus. You will not fail that exam. That interview shall go through. That good news shall come your way. You will be promoted. You will increase. You will increase. You will increase. Your ministry shall increase. You will increase. Finances shall not be a problem in your life anymore. God will beautify you like a water garden. In the name of Jesus. You will never run dry of anointing. You will never run dry of resources. In the name of Jesus. Lord, we bless you. Lord, we bless you. Lord, we bless you. We give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise. Thank you, Lord. Come on, thank him. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Give him a round of applause. Thank you, Lord. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. This is 2018.
Resources.
Amen. This year you will never run dry of grace.
Amen.
Where you failed last time, this year you will not fail again.
Amen.
You shall become the terror of your own terror.
Amen.
What has made you to be afraid before, you will make them to be afraid.
Amen.
Because God himself shall tabernacle with you.
Amen.
God will tabernacle with you.
Amen.
God Emmanuel shall live in you.
Amen.
Amen. He will carry you through.
Amen.
Affliction shall not come this
year. Amen.
The God that is with him is mighty.
Oh yes.
Save.
Oh yes.
He will quiet you with his law.
Oh yes.
He will rejoice over you.
Amen.
With singing. God will fill your mouth with new song.
Amen.
God will fill your mouth with new song.
Amen.
You will begin to rejoice.
Amen.
You will begin to dance.
Amen.
You will dance without music.
Amen.
You shall be well with your career.
Amen.
You shall be well with your business.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Say,
I am redeemed, but the Lord says so.
Amen.
I am redeemed.
Amen.
Let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich. He shall be well with you. This is your year. I speak increase to your life. I speak abundance to your life. You too will go to places. You too will go higher. The Lord.
Amen.
For they that know their God,
yes.
They that know their God, they shall break new ground.
Yes.
In this year, you shall break new ground.
Yes.
We are others, your contemporaries have not been before, you will be there.
Amen.
You will be the place setter.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The anointing that made Daniel to be excellent,
hallelujah.
That excellent spirit shall come upon you.
Amen.
That work, you shall be excellent.
Amen.
In your career shall be excellent.
Amen.
In your studies shall be excellent.
wisdom of God.
Amen.
The wisdom from above.
Amen.
That which has not been before shall be this year.
Amen.
That which has not been before shall be this year.
Amen.
How shall this be? The Holy Ghost shall come upon you. The power of the Almighty shall overshadow you. This is your year.
Amen.
This is your year of increase. God will expand you on all sides.
Amen.
To the north, in the east, to the west, and the south.
Amen.
Your sons and your daughters shall come from afar.
Amen.
And shall minister to you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Before you call for one, 10 shall answer.
Amen.
10 is the number of victims.
Yes.
And the 10th plague. And the 10th plague, even Egypt could not withhold Israel. By the prophet, Israel was delivered. By the prophet, Israel was preserved. This is your year of preservation. This is your year of deliverance.
Amen.
It shall be well with you.
Amen.
It shall be well with your body.
Amen.
God shall deliver you from the pestilence that fly in the noonday. God shall deliver you from the death that fly in the night.
Amen.
It shall be well with you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
This is your year.
Amen.
This is your season.
Amen.
God shall lift your hands up.
Amen.
When Moses was on the hill.
Yes.
When Moses was on the hill and Joshua was busy dealing with the Amalekites, every time the hands of Moses was lifted high, Israel always prevails. And every time his hands drops, Amalekite will prevail. In this year, your hands will not drop.
Amen.
God will lift your hands up.
Amen.
God will lift your hands up.
Amen.
The hand of the Lord shall come upon you.
Amen.
When Hadad rode on the horse and he went ahead to the gate of Jezreel, while he has gone, the hand of God came upon Elijah.
Oh, yes.
And Elijah was lifted in the realm of the spirit.
Oh, yes.
And he that started ahead came last. And he that started late came first.
Oh, yes.
There shall be a swapping of position.
Yeah.
Where you have failed, you shall win.
Amen.
Where you have been behind, you shall come forward.
Amen.
This is your year.
Amen.
It shall be exceeding abundance for
you.
What your eyes can perceive, your hands will achieve.
Amen.
The hand of God, the right hand of God, shall come upon you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
How shall this be? God himself will lift you up.
Amen.
God will perform it.
Amen.
There is no mountain anywhere except the one you put in your heart. But for now, don't put any mountain there.
Amen.
Whatever God has done is forever.
Amen.
Nothing can be added.
Amen.
Nothing can be removed.
Yes.
Whatever God has said, it's forever.
Amen.
He will do it.
Amen.
This is your year.
Amen.
Year of performance.
Amen.
Whatever goal that God has given you, I show you, God will perform it.
Amen.
It is God that is going to work in you.
Amen.
What to will and to do of his own pleasure.
Amen.
Don't say never. Don't say never, for with those that believe, all things are possible.
Amen.
God of possibility is your God.
Amen.
He is your Emmanuel.
Amen.
This year, Emmanuel shall support you.
Amen.
Emmanuel shall lift you.
Amen.
Emmanuel shall make you prevail.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Resources shall come to you.
Amen.
From the north,
yes,
and the east,
yes,
and the west,
amen,
and the south.
Amen.
You shall begin this year with testimony.
Amen.
With testimony.
Amen.
Good news of great joy shall come your way.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus,
amen,
you shall be well with you.
Amen.
Welcome to the year of exceeding abundance.
Amen.
Welcome someone by your side. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Blessed be
Make us complete in every good work, doing His will, Amen.
If you need any transportation, please, there's a church bus there. Just hang it around so that we can take you. Happy New Year to you.
Happy New Year.
Okay. Yeah.